Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to show you three different ways to copy conditional formatting in Microsoft Excel. So the first way we are going to show you how to copy conditional formatting in Microsoft Excel is by using the Format Painter up here. The second way we are going to go over copying conditional formatting is by using the Paste Special option. And the third way we are going to show you how to copy conditional formatting is by using the Conditional Formatting button right up here in the ribbon. Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that. So let's go over our first method. We're going to use the Format Painter here. So I can see if I highlight the first row and I go over here to Conditional Formatting and I go to Manage Rules, I have already set up a rule right here for my conditional formatting, but it only applies to row 2, A through E. So I'm going to close this. And once I've highlighted the cells where I have conditional formatting, if I click right here on the Format Painter on the Home ribbon, and then I click A3 and hold my mouse button down and go all the way over to E3 and then go down on all of my data and let go, I can see that my conditional formatting has, in fact, been copied to the rest of my data set. And I know that because my conditional formatting rule highlights in red all of the risk types that are a high.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
The second way I can copy conditional formatting is to highlight the cells where I have conditional formatting. Right-click and go to Copy, and then I can select the cells where I want the conditional formatting to be copied to, go here to Paste, and go to Paste Special. And then when the Paste Special box comes up, I'm going to click the option for Formats and say OK. And I can now see that that conditional formatting has been applied to the rest of my data. And again, everything that is a high-risk type has been highlighted in red. And my final option for conditional formatting is I can just highlight the conditional formatting that I have. And if I click on conditional formatting and go to Manage Rules, I can see that my range goes to E2. Now I have two options here. I can duplicate this rule, and then I can click this up arrow, and I can pick the additional range that I want to apply that rule. Click this arrow again and say OK. And I can see that the high has been highlighted in red. But if I hit Control Z and I click on Conditional Formatting and I go to Manage Rules, if I click this up arrow, I can actually just apply this rule to all of the data in my table by starting with row 2 and dragging all the way down to the end of my data set, which is row 39. Click this arrow again and say OK. And then if I click Conditional Formatting and go to Manage Rules, I can just see that this rule has been extended from row 2 all the way down to row 39. If you would like further explanation on any of these options for copying conditional formatting, you can visit our blog. I will include the link to that entry in the description below on YouTube. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.